last of the 11. All set. They're off. In the 100 running of the Tattersall's Irish 2000 Guineas over 1 mile, and in the early stages, it's Max Sweeney in the grey jacket showing the way to Emporio as they settle down, heading for the elbow. They're closely followed by Poetic Flair, and away to the right is Rebel Step in the stripes, slotting in and behind the leaders. In the blue cap is Van Gogh and Lucky Vega tracking them as they come round the elbow. And it is Max Sweeney and Rory Cleary cutting out the running from Emporio Rebel Step, and they're followed by Van Gogh, and right in behind them is Poetic Flair and La Barossa. And these are being followed by Agrimony, the red hat in between horses. Manassib is towards the back with Wembley and the Rastafarian at the rear of the field. They've passed the halfway stage and all coming right of center with just over 3 to go. They're beginning to close up. It's Max Sweeney just in front from Rebel Step, Poetic Flair, Emporio. On the far side is Van Gogh, then Manassib, Agrimony and Wembley, and then Lucky Vega and the Rastafarian racing towards the final 2 furlongs, and it's Max Sweeney challenged by Van Gogh. On the far side is La Barossa with Poetic Flair and then Emporio. Manassib is next. The racing to the final furlong and a half spread across the track. It's Max Sweeney attempting to fight him off one by one. Poetic Flair on the near side. The far side is Van Gogh. Jim Bulger has the winning of it. It's Max Sweeney on the far side of Poetic Flair. Max Sweeney and Rory Cleary, a special day. Max Sweeney makes all in the Tattersall's Irish 2000 Guineas, beating stable companion Poetic Flair. Van Gogh next.
Max Sweeney 8-1 has won the Irish 2000 Guineas, making all at the Curragh in the 3:20 and holding Poetic Flair in the closing stages with Van Gogh home in third. Will Smith, Max Sweeney 8-1 the winner.
The Group 1 Vertem Futurity Stakes winner of last season as well, over a mile on heavy ground. He was obviously disappointing behind Bolshoi Ballet in the Derrenstown Stud Derby trial, but there were reasons for that, and if you kept the faith with him, which clearly Kevin Manning didn't do, Rory Cleary was the jockey of choice on this occasion, and Kevin Manning, I'm sure, will be thinking what might have been, though. It was only about half a head or so, a short head in it, wasn't it? Kevin Manning has ridden a cracker on Poetic Flair as well. And how tough is Poetic Flair, having run in the French Guineas last weekend? 2 weekends before that, he won the Newmarket English Guineas.